Raise your hand if you've heard of 3D printing. Okay. Raise your hand if you have one hand. I win. I have a follow-up question. Those of you who know me, you can't participate because that's just cheating. How many of you noticed I had one hand when I walked out on stage? Okay, I'm just curious. So yes, I have one hand, and I was actually born that way, which is quite common, and I'm sure you're wondering on how I lost my hand. And that's it, the dinosaur at Myrtle Beach. So growing up with one hand, a lot of people questioned how I was going to accomplish certain tasks, especially little things like tying my shoe, in which I did learn how to do, but in my defense, I learned how to do it in sixth grade. But Velcro is pretty popular of my generation. In the obstacles that I faced as a child, and people questioned me, for example, when I was very young, my mom, my first doctor's appointment, a doctor looked to her and told her that this is a two-handed world, and he questioned how I was going to make it. And I thought that was absurd, and so did she, and I'm glad that she didn't believe that. So when I, growing up and having one hand and having all these experiences, and especially having a great sense of humor about having one hand, I decided to start a blog called Form 5 to express and share my experiences having one hand. And in doing so, at the same time, I decided to go out on a limb, literally, and try my first prosthetic device. And I went down to Shriners Hospital in Kentucky. And I'm a very honest person, and I'm known for saying how it is. I appreciate the opportunity I had at Shriners Hospital, but the process itself was so lengthy, and the end result in the prosthetic that I got, I was so dissatisfied. And I realized that this was not a problem just for me, but it was also a problem in which a community that I'm in called the Limb Difference Community, and I didn't realize this until today, but it's actually Limb Difference Awareness Month. And the Limb Difference Community is an online community of blogs like myself of Form 5, just sharing and providing support with those with limb differences. And I realized that this is not a problem that I'm facing, but it's also a problem within the community that I'm in. So just like every problem that I've had in my life, I assess it and then I explore a solution for it. And in some cases, it's a one-handed solution. So when I realized that this was a problem, I started to explore other options. And at the same time, there was a maker movement going on that involved 3D printing. And I was 15 and a sophomore in high school, and I knew nothing about 3D printing. And I thought it was too expensive, and I definitely didn't think it was an option for the problem I had at hand. But in actuality, our school got a fab lab through a grant provided by MIT, and I was able to spend my sophomore year printing and innovating different types of prosthetics through 3D printing. And the first device I made in October of last year was unfortunately unsuccessful due to me not having enough wrist movement in my arm itself. But I, just like anything else, I let that setback push me one step further. And I went back into the fab lab, and in February of last year, I completed my first 3D printed prosthetic device in which I was actually able to put on, wear, and move. And at that moment, I knew that it was such, that 3D printing is such a life-changing technology that can be presented. And I really started to change what I was doing. So when I was in the Fab Lab, I worked with a group called e-Nable, which is a nonprofit organization that provides these low-cost 3D printed prosthetics. And with working with them, e-Nable is a really cool system, and they use open source. And what that means is all their files are online, and you're able to easily download them as long as you have access to a 3D printer. So in the Fab Lab, I collaborated with e-Nable, and I especially, after the first device didn't work, and I went and talked to them, and they provided me with the device that I ended up making in February. Even though the Fab Lab provided me with the final product, I knew that there was more that I could do. And I didn't want to stop there, and I knew that I probably should independently get my own equipment. So in April of last year, I started a Kickstarter campaign to raise $2,400 to purchase a 3D printer, and I really wanted to spend my summer mapping out and continue learning more about 3D printing. And on May 17th of last year, which is actually my birthday, I don't know why I'm telling you that, but I just kind of feel like telling you that. It was my birthday, I raised $2,400, and over the course of the summer, I learned how to do more 3D printing, and I created this device, which I think is the most effective device that I've made. And I've actually, before my TED talk, I was working on a newer device, and I ended up hating it, and I took it apart literally this week and put this one back together. So I'm glad that I have this, because I think this is probably the most effective device. And I'm sure many of you are thinking that I found a solution. The prosthetic I got from Shriners Hospital wasn't what I wanted, and now I've created something even better. But I don't want to just stop. I want to provide that service for others. And that's really where my blog has formed into something completely different. So instead of my blog I started 3 years ago that's just me sharing my experiences and all the funny things I did with having one hand and how I went to school and tied my shoe and now I'm driving with one hand, is now becoming something where I want to provide the service of this 3D printing technology and creating these prosthetics for others like myself. And the reason why I'm really here today is because a lot of people see change is out of their hands, and they don't think that they can make the difference in their lives. And the first, anyone can make a difference if they have enough drive and passion to do so. And just to view change is not out of your hands, and anyone can make a difference, whether you have one hand or two, 3D printed or not, the power to make a difference is in your hands. Thank you.